And we are joined now on the red carpet by the captain of the Pittsburgh Penguins, Sidney Crosby, nominated for the Hart Trophy, the Ted Lindsay, and of course the Art Ross Award recipient.
That's all?
Just to name a few, but Sid, good to see you here. Are you having fun?
Yeah, it's nice to be here. It's been a few years since I've been here, but obviously a big turnout and fun to be a part of this.
Well, we heard Kevin talking to PK Subban just a little bit earlier on the red carpet, saying you guys just flew in today from Vancouver receiving your gold medal ring. So just talk a little bit about that experience and what a whirlwind it's been for you the last couple days.
Yeah, it's been nice. I mean, you're away from things a bit. You get to see guys you played with. Obviously, a pretty special moment there. Great experience. So, seeing those guys again, we didn't have a lot of time to celebrate. We had to leave pretty soon after. So, it was nice to reminisce a bit. And then, obviously, coming here and knowing the excitement that's coming here. So, it was good to see everyone. And, you know, we're all kind of looking forward to next year now. Once we kind of turn the page here, the draft and everything starts, and we'll turn the page and get going.
Sid, what's the last few months been like for you? Obviously, the loss was a killer loss for you guys. Obviously, hurt the changes in the organization. You've been a very organization with no changes basically since you won the Stanley Cup. Now you've got a new GM, you're going to have a new coach, a new system. What's it been like for you?
It was difficult. You know, it stung for a while. You know, we had a great opportunity there up 3-1, and obviously the Rangers had a great run and deserved to keep moving on, but definitely stung for a while, and like you said, going through those changes, it's not easy. You know, ultimately the coach and the GM pay the price when the team doesn't deliver, so I think, you know, you put a lot of responsibility on yourself, and as a team, we put a lot of responsibility on ourselves, you know, dealing with that, so we'll have to be better and find ways to make sure it doesn't happen again, but it's part of hockey, we all know that, but it's never easy when you go through it.
So what does your schedule look like going forward here in the summer months? Where do you spend your time? What does the agenda look like for Sidney Crosby going forward?
Going home shortly, so that'll be nice. July, August, I'll spend most of my time at home and starting up another summer, getting ready for a season, and it'll be a bit more normal with the schedule and everything, you know, being just, you know, with this year, it was the Olympic schedule and so many things going on, it'll be nice to kind of get that regular schedule and routine. So, you know, I think players always kind of crave that routine, and I definitely do. Looking forward to next year.
Well, Sid, I coached a pretty good player at one time, and I used to pick his brains all the time. I'd bring him into my office, and I'd be asking about certain things and certain players, and I'm sure the same thing's going to happen with you when the new coach wants to talk to you. What has to happen in Pittsburgh? What has to change? You're so close. Like you said, 3-1. You know, you win one more game, you're going on the Stanley Cup final. What changes have to be made in Pittsburgh? Big changes, small changes?
I think small. I mean, it's a fine line, winning and losing, and ultimately you have to get those big plays, and you know, your best players have to be your best players, and you know, personally, I feel like you know, especially last playoff, it wasn't my best, and you have to find ways to, you know, get your team those big plays when they need them. So I think every winning team has that, and you know, like I said, we don't need to change a whole lot, but you know, I think enjoying the process is a big thing for us. We have so much pressure and expectation. I think we probably didn't enjoy the whole process this year, and you really have to enjoy it and have fun with it and embrace that pressure too.
Was Niskanen the biggest surprise you've seen? Did you expect that out of him at the start of the year when all the injuries started happening to your hockey club?
Yeah, it's amazing what happens when, you know, you're faced with adversity, and you know, a guy like Niski comes in and just you know, kind of carried the power play for a long time there, and you know, that's what happens. But it's fun to see teammates have success, especially given our situation and missing as many guys as we did. You know, guys held on pretty strong.
What qualities do you look for in a head coach going forward? Something that maybe would be attractive to you in a head coach?
I think any coach at the NHL level is going to be organized and demanding and going to ask for a lot of discipline from his team. So I think all those traits that get a coach to an NHL position, they don't change. And what gives you success, I don't think that changes, whether you're talking about LA or any other team. It's just who executes it the best. But I think, those things will always continue to be important. And at the end of the day, your players need to perform. You know, you can coach all you want, but the players have to be the ones that perform. So it's a partnership, but definitely, you know, the players are a big part of that.
I've always been interested in the relationship between superstars on a team. You and Malkin, do you guys talk during the summer? Do you basically leave each other alone during the summer? You see each other so much during the winter? Or do you, have you been talking about what's been happening in Pittsburgh, or do you just leave each other alone?
The odd time, you know what? Once we start getting closer to camp, you know, you can tell the anticipation. We start talking a little bit more, but you know, Gino went to World Championships, and then I've seen him on pictures and with a whale, or I don't know what was there, and then the one picture I saw online. So he looks pretty busy, but I think once we start getting closer to camp, I think the anticipation, and you know, they'll start to get excited about coming back over and everything. So we'll start to talk a little more as things move along.
Well, congratulations. congratulations on the Art Ross Trophy, and good luck here tonight with the other two awards. Thanks so much for taking the time to join us. Good to see you, Sid.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Sid.
Thank you.